Welcome students of class 4 to your new GK class, and today we are going to start with a new chapter, that is My Passport. Here we are going to learn about different types of documents which are the exact identity of yourself. You have to prove, sometimes you need to prove yourself that you are yourself and you are the citizen of this country. You need to prove that one many times regarding in many types of legal issues. Okay, so we are going to learn today what are these important documents, where are they needed, how are they useful, and what they are called. Okay, so the first one, the word passport comes from the two words passport word has been made, that is pass and port. So pass means to get an entry, whereas the port means the door. Okay, the port means door, and the passport is a document that helps you to pass safely through the door or enter the point of a country. This passport opens the door of another country for your entrance. That is called passport. Now, a passport is also the proof of identity, which means it can be shown to prove that you also really you. That means you really are you. Okay, this helps you to prove that one. Now, question number A, here one important point has been given in the cool fact. Let us read it out. Citizens of India do not need a passport to travel in some of the neighboring countries. And which are these neighboring? Two of them are Nepal and Bhutan. So they doesn't need any passport to travel in these countries. Okay. So here one passport picture has been given. You have been provided with one picture of passport, and there are some statements which we have to prove with the help of the picture that whether they are true or false. So let us see. Now the first one, you can see in the picture, we can see that there is written Republic of India, that is Bharat Ganrajya. This is one is the logo or the writing of our Indian government. Okay, it's a republic country. Now the first option we can go is type. Here it is written P. Actually, type of the passport is depending on for what purpose you are going to different country. P type passport is of blue color, and it's known as personal passport, and it has been given to common people, those who are going to different countries for holidays, for vacations, for studies. Okay, these are personal passport. Whereas another one is that is S, and that is S type passport is of white color. This S type of passport are the people who are going to another country representing our country for any type of government services. Okay, they are representing our country in the another country for any type of service. Those passport types are S. So it is having white cover. So this is the difference between P passport and S passport. Okay, so this is why it is mentioned type. Is it P type or S type? Means personal type or service type. Next comes country. As you know, it's India. Next comes passport number. Here is the passport number is been printed. In passport, your surname, that is usually we say title, actually it is surname. So surname is written first, and then after your name is written below it. Your surname will be written first, then after your middle name and first name. Okay, so here comes the passport pattern where the surname is written first, then after the name is written first. Maybe the first name first, second name, middle name second, next, but the last name, that is the surname, is written first. Now we can see that nationality has been mentioned. Here gender has been mentioned, male or female, and then after date of birth has been mentioned. We can see address has also been mentioned, where the place of birth, where you have taken, you were born, okay, that name of that place has been mentioned, city has been mentioned. Three dates are there, that is one date of birth, second one is date of issue, and the third one is date of expiry of this passport, when this passport is going to expire and you have to renew it. Okay, so let's see what are the statements and we will write the answers for them. The name of the passport holder is written below the surname. Yes, it is true. So question number A, one, it is true that, let me write in cursive, it is true that the surname is written below the name. The name of the passport holder is written below the surname. The number two, the age of the passport holder is shown on passport. The age of the passport holder is shown on the passport. Here, do you find any type of age written in the passport? No, date of birth is written, but age has not been mentioned. So it's a false statement. It's a false statement. Next comes number three. The details of the passport holder was written in both English and Hindi. So we don't find any type of other language except this one in the passport. It is written totally in English. So this is also a false statement. Next comes number four. There are three dates written on the first page of the passport. This is the first page and we can see three dates are written. One is date of birth, second is date of issue of the passport, and the third one is date of expiry of the passport. So yes, we can find three dates on the first page of the passport. So let us write down true. And the last one is number five. And number five is, the signature of the passport holder is on his or her photograph. So here we can very clearly see that there is no signature needed on the photograph of the passport. So it is false. The photograph should be clear, right? So here comes false. So this was the picture of the passport and the facts of the passport. Now we will go for question number B. Match this documents commonly used as identity card with their short descriptions. So these are few more identity cards of yours which proves that you are the citizen of this country, and we will today know about the name of this documents. Okay, so I hope all of you have written this one. So I'm going to write just over here beside this. If someone has not written, you can complete it. And here comes question B. So question B, match this documents commonly used as identity cards with their short descriptions. Number one, this card has a person's photograph on it and it permits one to drive motor vehicles. So to drive your motor vehicles, you need one permission that is known as, along with photograph. So that is known as driving license, and it is on C, number C. It's driving license. So the first one is driving license. Next, this is matched with one. C has been matched with 1. Now let's go for the number 2. Let's go for number 2. And here comes number 2. Number 2 is, this is a unique number having 12 digits for each person living in India and has a logo which looks like the rising sun. So it is Aadhaar card. So it's number B, sorry, it's number A. Number A, it is Aadhaar card. Aadhaar card, and here it comes, number 2. Now let's go for the next document where we can see a rising sun in our Aadhaar card. Number 3, this card is issued for a family that allows people to obtain food grains, oils and other essential things at low cost. So all of us know it's ration card. Yes, so it's B, ration card. It's ration card, and here it's 3. It has been matched with 3. B, ration card, has been matched with 3. Next comes number 4. This card is issued by Election Commission of India to those eligible to vote in elections in India. So here comes voter identification card. This is the card where it is being used in India or issued to the person who is eligible to vote for the country at the age of 18. So you would have seen with your parents, they are having their voter card, voter identification card. If you have not seen till now these type of documents, you just insist your parents to show you these types of documents. Which are these documents? You should at least know and identify them. Okay, so try to know and identify with the help of your parents. So here comes your D, that is voter ID card. I am writing ID card as the space is very little, and it will be matched with number 4. Next comes 5. This is a card with a 10 character code made up of letters and numbers issued by Income Tax Department. So Income Tax Department issues one card to the income tax payers of the country, and that card is known as PAN card. It is having 10 characters including letters as well as numbers. So you even go through this card of your parents. When you will grow up, you will also have these documents. So it's E matched with 5. E, that is PAN card, matched with 5. Okay? Do you have a school identity card? Yes, we all have. Those who are old students, they have their identity cards, which has been provided by Badwan Model School to all of you. Write down or write name of your school, draw or stick its logo, paste your passport size photograph and fill in other details. So here one identity card has been given to you. You have to paste one photograph, you have to paste the logo, or you can draw it with your hands, write the name of your school. Here you can write session, your roll number, last year's roll number, your photograph, your name, your parents' name, your date of birth and your class. So every type of document is there. Even the students are having their identity card, so that each and everyone, what is the objective effective to see the identity card, to know about the person in details or little bit about the person at the time of emergency. In your identity card, even the blood group has been mentioned, right? So at the time of emergency, if anyone needs blood, it can also be donated without any delay. So already even blood group has been mentioned. So these are some of the detailings in the card which gives the information about the person who is having it. So along with this, students, I will conclude my class over here, and I will be back again with a new class next Saturday. Till that time, take care of yourself and be healthy.